Hello everyone, welcome back to the Android Kenya channel, and today we are looking at this here is the Infinix 0x Pro. It is the what you can call the flagship of the new Infinix 0 series, so that's the 0x series. And this device is already available in Kenya. By the time you're getting to watch this video, it's already launched and on sale, and it's going for 37,000 shillings. As you can see from the packaging here, the device that I have with me is the 128 GB internal storage model that's paired with 8 GB RAM. So this is what will set you back some 37,000 shillings. And inside here, as you're going to see shortly, is the Nebula Black model. So if you have to run through some of the specifications, I'll put a link in the description to our specifications page on androidkenya.com. Other than the internal memory and the RAM, we are also getting a 4500 milliampere hour battery. This one runs on XOS version 7.6, which is still powered by Android 11. And we have on the front a pair of we have a 16 megapixel camera, and then at the back we have the flagship 108 megapixel camera that's flanked by an 8 megapixel ultra wide and another 8 megapixel periscope moonshot lens. At least that's what I've read Infinix is calling it. And we are going to see the display. It's a 6.7-inch AMOLED display with a difference. And in this device is a Helio G95 chipset, which is paired with MediaTek's intelligent display chipset for low game latency, reduced lag, those kinds of things. In short, we're expecting a battery smooth experience on this device. Much has been said, let's cut it open, see what's inside this glorious package. So there we are. This is what it looks like inside the retail packaging of the Infinix 0x Pro. So here is your Infinix 0x Pro in all its Nebula Black glory. We are coming back to this device in a while. You get this, and let's go inside here. Before I come back to this, let's see what is inside here. So there is this fly about how you can win some more phones, and here is your obligatory X Club coin, though this has the semblance of a note. And interestingly, for the first time ever, I'm seeing this SIM tray ejector pin getting some nice plastic packaging. So it's here, get rid of that, it's here. And then here's a nice case to go with that Nebula Black. So not clear, but looks very nice, should fit that device very well. And of course, here is your 45 watt charging brick for juicing up that 4500 milliampere hour battery unit in the 0x Pro really fast. Of course, USB Type-C, and you still do get a pair of earbuds. Nothing new here, pretty much what we've seen from Infinix before, and they're nicely labeled left, right, so you don't confuse those. These aside, let's come back to the hero of the show, the 0x Pro. So here is the device itself. As I've shared earlier, we do get what they're calling a periscope moon shot lens. So that's the one that with the telescope zoom and all of those things. And a 108 megapixel hero sensor here with ultra night vision. And then we get the dual chip coming from the Helio G95 and the MediaTek intelligent display chip. And then 6.67 inch of full HD plus AMOLED and ultra smooth display. The ultra smoothness will come from the fact that here for the first time we're seeing Infinix go all the way up to 120 hertz refresh rate for its displays. Previously we were stuck at 90, and yeah, that's the tri camera arrangement at the back, and that's your quad LED flash. Let's get rid of this polythene. Gone. Here's our device. This is our 16 megapixel snapper. On the side is our power button, and we get a volume rocker. And on the side is our SIM tray. Down here we do have USB type C port. There's a mic. There's bottom firing speakers, and there's a 3.5 millimeter headphone jack. The earpiece, I can't seem to see the earpiece, so I'm interested in seeing where it's incorporated, but I can't see it anywhere here, which is an interesting way of doing the design. When taking the photos, I'll see where I can trace it to and share that. Otherwise, they should have gone the route of Xiaomi, Vivo, and others that we've seen before, of incorporating it as part of the display and all of that. And at the back, let's get rid of this. At the back, there's this nice starry galaxy design. The marketing around this one is that you're able to take very clear shots of the moon and everything. So here you have a galaxy constellation like pattern going on at the back, and it looks so nice. I'm keen to see if it's a fingerprint magnet. It doesn't look to be. So that's very exciting. I don't know what sort of material it is, but this is looks very glassy and all those kinds of things. So yeah, here is our Infinix Zero X Pro. This is the hero device in Infinix's entire smartphone lineup, and it does look the part. When you place it on a table like that, this there is some wobble. Let's see if it that is offset when you put the case. So here's our case. There's still the protrusion, so doesn't do much to change things. Yeah, it still wobbles on the table, but that case fits so nicely and it's so good. Let's power on our device and see what else we are getting with the Infinix Zero X Pro. There we go. Welcome to XOS 7.6, which is based on Android 11, as you can see here. Android 12 is on the way. That much has been made clear. And there we are. So this is the welcome screen, the home screen of the Infinix Zero X. You get that nice wallpaper. There should be others that you can choose from here. Yeah. And doesn't look to be much really. We are getting the game zone. We've seen this before on Infinix devices. And then your XLR bar app, high translate. There's an app called Folax. I have no idea what that is. We've always had the freezer. And AHA games, Boom Play. There's lots of other things that I'd consider bloat, like Scoopa News and the like. So let's go into the settings and see the display settings. The screen refresh rate is set to auto, even though you can lock it to 120 for very battery smooth animations, or stay with the standard 60 hertz for the standard refresh rate, but also to save on some juice. That should be pretty much it. Nothing out of the ordinary, nothing strange here. Yes, Infinix is delivering a standard XOS experience that many will be able to relate with. Yeah. As I have said, this device is going for 37,000 shillings. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and keep it on AndroidKenya.com for further in-depth analysis of this device and eventually dissection of its various features and a review that's on the way.